Turns out it's hard to, like, do shit when you got a
I like that you came here to sleep as well.
Yeah, I'm just like, I'm just gonna lie in a pit.
I came here because I'm just, I've been, like, staring into space. So I don't know what to do. I'm just kind of fiddling around.
Hello, welcome to hell.
I like it down here. This way. It's cozy. I get to be in proximity to my favorite man.
Kinda wish it wasn't an abandoned mine shaft down here.
Mm.
There's moss down here.
Yeah, Frank, what are you doing growing moss down
here? And a staircase?
Oh, did you actually just find the way back up? I think you might have just found the way back up. Sick.
My thumbnails in Mabini Talks have been fun to do as well.
Oh, yes.
Do this for safety.
Oh. Lapis here, too.
Careful. It's not a one layer of lava, so.
It is over here. Yes, you were saying about your thumbnails?
Yeah, they've been fun to do. I think my approach to making videos is kind of just like have fun doing it at the moment. So, rather than. I think it's in talks. The thumbnails are always like, in the video it's serious, in the video it's whatever it is, sort of passionate, whatever. But in the thumbnails it's kind of just goofy, and I'm like, that's a funny face I'm pulling, I'm gonna make that the thumbnail. And then I'm, so it's like Doctor Who acting, and then I've got this silly face that I've pulled.
You've been watching more Doctor Who?
Not recently. But at the time that I recorded the videos, that was
How much backlog do you have?
That's it. That's done now. That's I try to come. I need to come up with more ideas, but like, the ideas that I have are always like, it's a sensitive topic, and I kind of don't really want to talk about that stuff. So then I go, all right, I got to think of something that's easier to talk about. It's not. That's just something that I would enjoy talking about. So I'm like, maybe I just tell some stories or something, and I can't think of.
That could be good. Storytime YouTubers are very well popular.
Yeah. I'm just thinking of stuff that I want to do. That's stuff that I will enjoy doing. That's what I'm focusing on. Not worrying about what's popular. The Doctor Who stuff's actually been doing pretty well, so that's been good. And the Dawn of War 2 stuff on Mabini Games have been.
Yeah, I saw them. I like that you were telling me about them for weeks, and then it came out and it was like 5 minutes long. I was like, oh, all right.
That's it.
Well, like, it was like 3 minutes or something.
Like, the actual, like, I'm like, do I want them to be 20-minute long videos? And I thought, no. How?
Dude, I don't know.
It's just, they're just like the bits where I say something, and that's pretty much it, unless like it's the end of the game. And
I don't know what the hell is going on with me and my video lengths. Every video I'm making is just getting longer and longer and longer.
What is going on with this wall?
So, like, again, I'm presuming that the Cheater's Lament vid will be out by the time, oh my god, that this video will come out. It's gotta, right?
Yeah.
Definitely. That video is 8.5 minutes long, right?
Yeah.
In that video, I talk about the history of one fucking hat in this game.
Yep.
The first video in the series, where I talk about the Gold Rush update, which added the medics, new weapons, the achievement system, the new map, and a new game mode, that video is 6 minutes long.
Oh.
And I'm like, what the hell? Somehow I've slowly been like just making my videos longer and longer. Fairly innocuous things like TF2 moments, for instance. They used to be comprised of just one recording session.
Yep.
Where and I would just play for like 3 hours, and then I'd just like just put all together all the best bits, and that'd be it. The most recent one is comprised of at least 3 recording sessions. It's the same length. I'm just like, what the hell? I don't know, my standards are slowly growing and I don't realize it.
Yeah, it's just a sign that you're taking what you're doing seriously, you know? You're like, at least a part of your brain, part of your brain's like, if I'm gonna do this, we're doing it.
Well, yeah, and I like having that mentality with been for making YouTube videos. I don't try and keep anything a certain length as much as I just make it as long as it has to be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is why the war update video is like 28 minutes long or something like that. It's just like,
yeah, I just want my videos to be fun to watch. So I just kind of chop out everything that's slightly boring. Like, I chop out bits in my Beanie Talks, and every Talks video ends abruptly. Like, I just finish what I'm saying, and I'm like, well, I kind of just ramble and talk shit for the end of it, and then I just chop that whole bit out. So just...
Yeah, you've been doing good at editing. Your Mabini talks are...
They just sort of stop quite well every paced. Time. It's like... Yeah. Fanny sometimes uploads, like, a little video that's just a little random thing.
It brings me great joy.
Yeah. And you're like, oh, look, it's Frank.
Frank.
I don't see how that works, yeah. But okay.
Been 72 hours since a Frank video.
God, I wish. That means it would have just come out.
Yeah.
Frank doesn't seem to realize that when we say we like Frank video, we legitimately do it. I like your videos.
My holy crap. Well,
it's more so I just don't understand.
Hmm. Alright. What am I gonna do with this? Stupid. Sit down somewhere.
I need an air pocket.
Actually, sit here. I think I kind of take it one channel at a time, unintentionally. I just focus on each channel at different times. I'm like, I've been doing enough Mabini Talks. When was the last Mabini Games video? It was 6 months ago. Okay, I should probably make another one.
That's because you take all your channels equally as seriously, I think. Yeah. Whereas, like, for me, like, my drawing channel is just, like, if I have something to post, usually, like, an animation from the main channel, then it goes there.
Yeah.
If I have, like, a shitpost video that's nothing, I'll put it on my second channel.
Talks, every time I edit a Talks video, it inspires me to make another one. So I think the only way to make Talks videos is by watching old Talks videos and then just going, I want to do more of this. And just do it like that.
Yeah.
With Mabini Games, it's kind of... It comes down to... Do I have an idea of what I want to do? Supercars Mabini is just...
I was hoping it wasn't going to push you away.
Spending the time doing it, I think.
Yeah.
Which shouldn't be hard, because it's not hard. I just have to press record and do it. Because it's just me ranting about... Supercars, it's nothing fancy.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's difficult to find that balance of, like, how much effort you want to put into videos and stuff. Getting a formula or whatever.
That crabby. My current philosophy is
TF2 update history. I basically put my all into it. I have a philosophy is, like, if I come up with an idea, I just gotta do it. Doesn't matter how time consuming and, like, difficult it is, I just do it. Whereas TF2 Moments, or anything like that, I'm just like, I got a formula for this. I'll just follow that.
Mm. Oh, that's a spider. That's a spider.
An arachnid.
It's definitely a spider. I'm just going to run away.
Yep, that's definitely a spider.
Yep, that totally happened. Did I just say that out loud?
I hate the fact that I do say that, like, unironically. Well, I say it as a joke, but unironically as a joke. Oh, that's lava.
Ooh.
Oh, that's lava.
Oh, it's bad.
Okay.
Yeah, anything with my video production as well is that I feel that I'm going to be behind on all the memes. The Dr. Livesley meme is probably going to be dead and gone by the time my video comes out. I feel like it already is. Whatever, man. I did it because it was funny.
Yeah.
Just came up with the idea and I'm like, I want to do this. And so I did.
Yeah.
This is it. This video, this Cheetah's Lament video, I expected it to be between 3 to 5 minutes.
Yep.
That's how long I thought the video would be.
Yeah. And
just a measly
and where did
that
get you?
I think the main thing problem for me is just that I've been working on my house, and so I haven't been haven't had that spare time to actually make the videos.
Yeah, that was the thing I was going to say, is like that's been your main focus. Yeah. And all your spare time you put into doing that, so... It is what it is.
Yeah.
But one day the house will be done.
It will be.
And then who knows?
Then I'll be in my room working on my videos in a different house.
Hell yeah.
Okay, how much we got left? Ooh, that's not... The numbers are not looking good. Survey says more obsidian may be needed.
Survey says mob.
Survey says... We should play Family Feud.
No.
I like that game show. Why?
Because I think it's a silly idea of a show and we don't have an audience.
You don't need an audience. There's video games for this sort of thing.
But isn't... Yeah.
The family it's part of it's unnecessary. I just like the questionnaire and percentage percentiles. I think it's interesting. Personally, but I guess some people... Some people ain't too into that concept.
I can't see. Let's see.
Fine, Mabini, what's your favorite game show?
Oops.
What are you, some kind of deal or no deal kind of guy or something?
No.
Oh,
Wheel of Fortune?
That was a huge diamond vein. Let's go.
I like Hard Quiz.
Hard Quiz?
Yeah, where people... It's on the ABC. And people bring in their... They have their special topics that they talk about. And so they'll get asked questions about their specialist topic. And if they... Like, you get negative points if you get questions wrong. And people get chucked out at the end of the round. And then it's like a head-to-head at the end. And whoever answers the most questions correctly wins.
That's pretty cool. What's your favorite game show, Franklin?
I don't know. I think I'd have to say probably... Family Feud.
Hey. Two against one. Family Feud night. Ding ding ding.
I also like how silly like the Price is Right can get sometimes, but I think overall I think I prefer Family Feud.
Here's my thing with the Price is Right. I am probably the literal worst person in the world at determining prices at
this.
I don't know about that.
I don't think there's anyone worse than me.
All right, new, same industries idea. The Price is Right for the three of us.
Yeah.
Let's see who's the worst at the Price is Right.
I just, I expect everything in my life to be way more expensive than it is, which in a way is kind of a good thing because I'm always like slightly like, oh, that's good.
Yeah,
pretty. So like, I don't know, I'll get like something on my car fixed and I'm going to be like, oh man, how much is this going to cost? And so I'm like, oh, it's just going to be a couple hundred. Like, it won't be much. I'm like, what do you mean it won't be much? And then they're like, oh, you know, like it won't be that bad. I'm like, okay, was it going to be like $1,200? And like, what? No, this would be crazy. And I'm like, well,
if it's a car thing.
I'm like, well, I don't know.
If it's a car thing, I'm always like, it's probably going to cost like $1,000, and they're like, it costs $100. Is that it?
Yeah.
Is that all? That's fuck all.
I know. So, that like literally everything, I'm like, this is going to cost me fucking, I better put like
I'll never financially recover from this. I will never financially recover from this, and then you just do it.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh.
Okay. Easy.
Yeah, I constantly expect things are going to be way more expensive than
that. Oh, yeah, definitely.
What can it cost, Michael? $10? It's just a banana. And that's funny because it's the opposite of that. I don't think everything's expensive because I'm so superbly rich that everything is a thing. I'm just stupid. I just don't know. I'm worried all the time that I'm not going to have the money for things.
Yes, that is exactly the case. Or at least for me, anyways.
Chronically dumb.
So
yeah, we could play The Price is Right and just have a really bad fucking time.
Yeah, just see who's the worst.
The Price is Right. It's like Golf Score, you know?
Not to mention that The Price is Right would also be sectioned into... first off, they have different time periods that the games could be played in, so you've got to adjust for inflation.
Yeah.
And different... Obviously, we've got Australia and America, which the prices would be different just inherently. So...
Yeah, it's like...
just confuses
things. I've had sessions where I'll just, like, stream PS1 games, and I'll just be like, you know what? It's time to play PS1 Family Feud back in, like, the year 1990. And then you have to go, how fucking were people in the 1990s?
I like the NES one. Oh, the SNES one, sorry.
Oh, yeah.
I like the funny music. It sounds like a fucking like barnyard.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think we should play Family Feud.
I remember me and Seb were playing, and then one of the questions was like something about screens in your home, and we had gotten 2X's at that point, and I was like, no, wait, Seb, hold on. This is the 1990s. They're talking about a screen door. They're definitely talking about a screen door. And he's like, no, you're insane. And when I did screen door, it was the number one answer. I'm like, yes, the boomer energy is flowing in me. I know what the boomers are thinking.
Can I tell you something funny about the SNES version? I don't know if it's the same as the PlayStation 1 version.
Yeah.
But the way that the computer works, that it reads your answers, is that it makes sure that like the answer, that you have the letters in your answer in the right order, right?
Right.
So, say the answer is like bed, right?
Yeah.
If you were to write fucking bachelor Barty with like a B, so have B, E, and B in that order,
yeah,
it would still count as bed.
Oh, yeah.
I believe. Because I saw a speed run of it, and that's what they did. They just kept writing like insane words that weren't the answer at all, and it worked.